During World War II, the United States government spent $2 billion developing manufacturing facilities for the production of weapons-grade uranium and plutonium. However, these facilities were not designed to manufacture enough material for just one or two bombs.
Will it be big enough? Big enough to scare the hell out of all of us and make us stop and think? Big enough to stop all war forever? If you want to ask the question, you ask that.
Look, that I've seen Oak Ridge, all right? And that place wasn't built to make one or two bombs. It was built to make thousands of them. Thousands.
Immediately after the end of World War II, production was vastly increased. This was due to the new emerging threat of communist expansion. The cost of producing the fissionable material needed for nuclear weapons made this material practically priceless. The U.S. Atomic Energy Commission would have to ensure that this material could not be lost, stolen, or destroyed, no matter where it was stored. Nuclear capsule storage structures. The A structures. The A structures were designed by Black and Veatch Company through a contract with the Kansas City Engineers. Storage structure A was designed to appear as a two-story structure. The second story was never accessible. The structure was constructed of heavily reinforced concrete throughout. The blind windows, made of concrete and covered with double-pane 3-inch thick glass, were never operable. At the entrance, a straight run of 6 concrete steps led to a raised concrete platform that was sheltered by a flat roof. At the end of the platform was a concrete enclosure with a doorway. Sheltered by the enclosure was a heavy steel door. This door led to a small room within the 10-foot-wide walls of the structure. A bank-type vault door then led to an interior corridor. The corridor contained 4 vaults, 2 on each side. Each vault had a solid bank vault-type door with 2 combination locks. Each vault was 10 feet wide and 13 feet long. Storage Structure A was the first nuclear capsule storage building. It was designed to withstand a direct hit in case of an attack. During its early history, it was the most defended structure on the site. The structure was 10 feet thick on the sides, 10 feet thick on the bottom, some of which is buried below ground, and more than 14 feet thick above the ceiling of the vaults. Inside each vault were permanently installed steel racks of shelves. There were 16 full racks, 3 shelves per rack, and 4 single racks, 3 shelves per rack. The total number of shelves equaled 60. On each shelf was stored a unique device, referred to as the birdcage. Subsequent structural effects testing of nuclear weapons led to the determination that the design of the A structure rendered it top-heavy. The structure could be toppled and subsequently destroyed by the precursor wave of a weapon detonated at an exceptionally low altitude or at the surface. This information led to the design of a new storage structure, the A-2 structure. Storage structure A-2 was also constructed of reinforced concrete and was like the A structure internally. The structure appeared to have a single story above a basement level, but the above-ground level was never a usable space. Its interior could not be accessed, and its apparent windows and door openings were never operable. The eastern elevation of the false structure had a blind doorway placed off-center and blind windows as well. A basement-level entrance was provided on the eastern elevation. A short concrete stairway led to a concrete loading dock with a flat roof. A single doorway provided access to the 34-foot-long corridor that led to a small room contained within the exterior wall of the building. Beyond this room, the interior was identical to that of the A structure. This structure was constructed on the side of a berm, and most of the structure was below ground. The vaults were deep below ground with over 20 feet of solid reinforced concrete above them. The structure maintained a low profile which would have been unaffected by the blast wave of a surface or near-surface detonation. In addition, the interior vaults had single combination, thinner steel doors, rather than the heavy bank vault-type doors of the A structures. In the newer A2 structure, the storage shelves were 30 inches wide, as compared to 36 inches in the older A structure. This reduction in shelf size was a result of a change in the composition of the nuclear capsules, including the primary, fission, and the newer secondary, fusion, units for thermonuclear weapons. The A2 structure represented the new and improved model in nuclear primary and secondary storage. Advancements in nuclear weapons design led to the development of the sealed pit concept. The sealed pit allowed for the nuclear primary, plutonium sphere, to be permanently installed into the weapon upon initial assembly. By 1960, the sealed pit weapons replaced most of the older designs and the nuclear capsules became obsolete. This also rendered the A structures obsolete, and they were no longer used.